Now let's understand how do we perform swapping in various other programming languages and what is the difference when we perform swapping in Python. So over here we have two variables A and B, A containing 10 and B containing 20. If we were to swap both of these variables, that is if you want A to contain 20 instead and B to contain 10 instead, how would we perform that in various other programming languages? First of all, we have printed A and B over here. So A and B initially contain 10 and 20 respectively. So now we use this hash symbol to comment a particular statement in Python, which we have already seen in our previous video session. So supposedly we have taken a third variable, which we usually do while performing swapping in various other languages. So what we have done is A contains 10 initially, and we have assigned this 10 value to this variable, new variable temp, so that A becomes empty now. So now what we have done, we have assigned the value of B, which contains 20, into A. So in this statement, what we have done, we have assigned 20 to A. Now B becomes empty. So what we have done in the third statement, we have assigned temp a 10 earlier. So we have assigned a 10 to B now. So now when we print B over here, we have 20 and 10 instead. This is how we perform swapping generally in various other languages. Now, how do we do that in Python? Let's open another set of code. Let's get rid of this. Let's open swapping in Python. We have the output over here. So we have the output over here. Now over here again we have two variables, A containing 10 and B containing 20. We have printed both of these variables and have a look, we have 10 and 20 respectively in A and B. Now we have printed swap the two numbers, and what we are doing is we are assigning A and B different values in one single statement, which means that Python supports multiple assignment of variables. We are collectively assigning two variables, two different values, which we cannot do in any other programming language. So when we say A comma B is equal to B comma A, what it is going to do, it is going to assign this particular value present in B inside this particular value A, variable A, and it is going to assign this particular value of variable A inside this particular variable B. So it is going to do respective assignment of values. The first value goes inside the first variable and the second value goes inside the second variable. So what is contained in B? B contains 20, so it is get passed on to A. And what is A? A contains 10, so it is get passed on to B. So now when we print A and B, look at this, we have a 20 and 10 instead. So that is how you perform swapping in Python. Let's remove this. Let's have another set of code over here. Now we can perform various arithmetic operations over variables as well. Let's have a look how we can do that. So let's find out the output. So we have these set of outputs over here. So we have two numbers present over here, number 1 and number 2. And we have assigned 10 and 20 values to these numbers respectively. Now what we are doing is, if we want to add both of these numbers through the addition operator, we can simply use the addition operator separating both of these variables, number 1 and number 2. So we have 10 plus 20, which comes out to be 30. So we are just printing the sum. So print sum is going to give us a 30 over here. Now similarly, we can perform subtraction as well. So when we say difference, we have taken a variable diff. And what we are saying, number 1 minus number 2, number 1 contains 10, number 2 contains 20. So it will evaluate 10 minus 20, which comes out to be a minus 10. So when we print the difference and call the variable diff, look at this, we get a minus 10 over here, like we do in arithmetic normally. Now we have a third variable, number 3. We have assigned the value 5 to this variable number 3. And what we are doing is, whatever sum we have calculated, we are multiplying the sum with this number 3. So we are multiplying the sum calculated above with the third number. So we have another variable mul over here standing for multiply. And when we say sum multiplied by number 3, what it is going to do? Sum contains nothing but 30 and number 3 contains 5. So we have 30 multiplied by 5, which gives us a 150. So when we print multiplication mul and call the variable mul, it is going to give us a 150. Now we can simply print a particular statement in Python as well. We simply have to use the print statement, and inside single quotes we can pass anything which gets off printed. So when we say Python is an interesting language, it is simply going to print Python is an interesting language over here. So that is how you perform simple arithmetic operations and printing operations in Python. That's all for this video.